supposed to rain till tomorrow afternoon. If that's the case, I'll go tomorrow morning as late as I can before I get rained out. And then maybe Thursday morning a little more before I get here tonight. But it's going well. Cruising right along today. And my tires, when I first pulled in the field, I was kind of like, oh boy. It's the 20th if I can't get these videos spliced together. Towards where it's wetter, and actually the field's drier than when I first pulled in. My tires aren't slicked over as bad anymore as they were, but you can definitely tell there's still moisture on the dirt. Pulling a sprayer on a side hill is kind of tricky. You really got to get over and hug that row, because the sprayer, as you can imagine, all that weight wants to slide. So if you don't want to run a row of corn over, you really got to hug. I'm really hugging this corn row, and the sprayer is really hugging this corn row, the 30 inches over. We're just barely negotiating it right now on this side hill. I can boom up a little bit here. It's a pretty slick way. He was just briefly telling me why he went with Y-drops yesterday. They said they see like a 5-bushel increase an acre versus broadcasting the urea like we did in the spring. Some guys will do that again right now. They'll go down the rows and spread out the pellet urea, dry urea. Obviously, that's just kind of scattered. Whereas what we're doing with those hoses right on the stalk, we're making sure that nitrogen, all the nitrogen, gets right to the corn. So they said they see a little increase in that aspect. They also said, got a hot row here again. The planter, this is when we were trying to figure out the GPS, it was going a little goofy. But they also said they see a 5-bushel increase or somewhere in there when there's nitrogen on both sides of the stalk because of the way the plant works. When there's, the hoses, there's one on both sides of the stalk versus just one side, where like maybe an injector, those toolbars are only injecting on one side. They said that this will, they see more better yield increase when you can get it on both sides like this does. Obviously, if we had a self-propelled equipped with these, you could go when the corn's a little taller. Guys do it when it's pretty tall. But, we take what it is. The 4630 chugs right along. It's been running well for us. If we had a front wheel assist tractor, it probably would be chugging through this, the greasiness a little better. The tractor does like to sink with the just two-wheel drive, the front ends on these. Anybody that's drove these types of tractors before knows the front ends like to sink, especially with a loader on the front and all that extra weight. So, but it's just kind of one of those things. It is nice to have the loader. If you do get into a hairy situation, you make a mess in the field, but you can push yourself backwards with the loader a little. So, but it's going well out here. The corn looks well. Next to the neighbor's field, I know they plant decal or whatever, GMO corn. That was looking pretty tough yesterday, not gonna lie. And, our non-GMO stuff next to that looked pretty darn good. It's probably a lot to do with timing on when it was planted. But at the same time, you can't knock the non-GMO completely. It's done well. I really don't see a lot of weeds out here, and that's part of the reason I think he switched. That's part of the reason he switched is because over the years, weeds in the area at least have built up this tolerance to the Roundup and the sprays that go along with the Kelp and the Pioneer corn, where it's non-conventional. Go back to that, he hasn't done it all here in 15-20 years or whatever. The weeds haven't seen that type of spray in a while, so they don't have that tolerance. So that was part of the sale, that the sales guys were like, hey, you're gonna knock them weeds out of the ballpark. So far so good. I mean, I really, like I said, I don't see a lot of weeds. It looks good out here. The corn's starting to come along. Same thing with Travis out there in Wisconsin, Houston Brothers. They're cultivating, and I know he said it's starting to get pretty tall on him. One of his videos, I'm pretty sure he said. So, everybody's, you know, the corn's coming right along. So, we'll take what we can, and it's a little greasy along this waterway. Down what I can. I'm at 51.4 acres of this field. I got easily at least 10 acres left that I have to get through. 10 acres, but there's a wet hole right in front of me. I also have to go fill in that other side of the wet hole I did, so I'm going to probably get a good 60 acres of it sprayed. What am I down to? Down to 600 gallons or so. So I'm putting 800 down in 50 acres. Terrible with math on the go. Around like 16, 17 gallons an acre. I think this GPS might be counting a little high on my acres, but I'll bump it up a little bit. Bump it up a little bit. Part of it has to do with my speed. If I stay around 5.2, 5.3, my control monitor here says I'm going 20 and a half to 21. I hit these wet holes, I'm kind of speeding up to push myself through them and carry some momentum. When I'm going like 5.6, 5.7, you know, my monitor says I'm down at like 18.2, which we think this is a little high for what the display, what it's actually doing. One of those huge wide drops could be plugged too. That could be an issue too. I don't know. It's hard to tell unless you run a lot of product through there. But when I fill up, he said he's never had them plugged really in the last 2 years. But I don't think I am either. I think I'm getting a lot of material out. That's a lot of stuff coming out. 20 gallons an acre, that's pretty high. You know, even anywhere in this 18, 17 to 20, that's pretty darn good. So we're cranking the nitrogen on. I am going 5.2 miles an hour right now, right along some mud, but I'm putting 21 gallons down right now, so I'll make up for it here. I'm on a side hill where the corn's kind of short. They always kind of are on these clay knobs, so the corn should grab onto this nitrogen and help give it a little boost here. Give her a little onions to get up the hill. The sprayer floats surprisingly well for how narrow of tires are on it. I took it through some. I sank down once in this whole field for about 50 feet. And I chuckered along, tractor didn't really bog, I didn't have to hit the dip lock or anything, but I had a good jig on, I probably had 1,200 gallons on when that happened. And it went well. So, I'll turn you guys off here for a little bit. I forgot to spin you forward, I just kind of got rambling. A little bit of a belligerent outburst, but I beg my pardon for that. And, turn around here and I'll probably shut you guys off. 1, 2, 3. A little bit of a belligerent outburst. So I'll get back to you guys here when I'm going around the wet hole. Maybe I'll show you guys a